In today's session, we will learn how to use the characters created in SPUM within a Unity scene. You can see that the character we created in the previous session is saved as shown on the screen. The created character can be checked both in the Unity scene and in the Unity project. If you go to the SPUM resources folder in the Unity project, you will find a units folder. You can see that the characters created through SPUM are saved in the units folder under SPUM's resources. The name of each prefab starts with SPUM underscore and is automatically followed by a time code, which is how the prefab is created. When you select each prefab, you can see various information in the inspector on the right side of the screen. You can see that the information we set up using a Unity C# script for the SPUM prefab is saved. Looking at this part briefly, you can see that the information about the SPUM package used to create the unit is saved. So, if you want to modify this data again in the SPUM manager and the package is missing, an error may occur. Each part is stored by type in the image element, and the items are saved in a location called item path, as shown below. It shows which sprite data is mapped and linked. If you want to manually change and use each part, you can access the corresponding part in the image element and check the data. The values set in the animation are stored in idle underscore list, move underscore list, and attack underscore list as shown below. Each list is added in order, starting from 0 and 1. So when we want to access them from the script, we can access idle underscore list 0, move underscore list 0, attack underscore list 0, and check the animation clip data. To make this access easier, SPUM provides a sample scene. In the project, go to SPUM and then sample, where you'll find a scene folder. Inside the scene folder, you will find the sample scene. Double-click the sample scene, and a green screen will appear as shown below. The current sample scene provides a simple code that allows you to check basic movement. And in the future, various samples will be provided to suit top view, side view, or other game scenarios. When you look at the sample scene, you will find the player manager, the player object, a canvas for UI, and an event system. If you select the player manager, you can check the player manager component in the inspector on the right. By clicking Create Unit, you will see the characters we created in the SPUM manager appear, as shown below. Additionally, by adjusting the start pos, add pos, column number, or unit max count, you can change the initial positions of the units. Let's change the start pos x to 0, y to 0, and modify add pos to 2. Then, by clicking Create Unit, you can see the units appear more centered. When you press play, you can see the basic animations assigned to the units playing. By clicking on the unit, you can view the pre-mapped animation information. If you click on the unit and move it, it will move according to the preset script. If you click on another unit and move it, in this case, the spear movement animation will be applied, so you will see it moving differently. Although the unit on the right is holding the same spear, it moves with the default animation settings because the animation data is different. You can also access and use pre-mapped animations through the menu at the bottom and see examples of them. Let me briefly introduce how these scripts work. The objects created now are placed in a unit pool called PlayObject, and they are placed in the PlayerObject pool. So, you can see that three objects have been created. The prefabs that were saved earlier have a parent object with the same name as each unit, and they are arranged underneath. If you look at the top object, you'll see a capsule collider and rigid body have been created, and a script called PlayerObject is provided as a sample. If you double-click the PlayerObject and open the script, you can take a look at it briefly. The code here retrieves information from the SPUM prefab and links the animation lists. You can also see how the animation state changes when the unit is moving or stopped through the update function. An example code is also provided to change the predefined animation indices through setStateAnimationIndex. If you look at the code that creates the animation panel when the unit is selected in the player manager, it provides a simple usage guide on how to use the animation state, which can be helpful for reference. Since the current sample C is a test version, we plan to provide a more scenario-appropriate version in the future with a variety of possible animations. Once that update is available, I will create an additional video. I will end today's video here. Thank you.